Well, it has been great. Look at the Pelicans' last six games and where they rank in the NBA during that stretch. Uh-oh. Record at the bottom, 5-1, tied for first. Everything else, first and second.
Man, you can definitely call that the Zion Williamson effect, because when he comes in the game, this guy is a movable chess piece. In the NBA game now, where everybody's playing small ball, he's a unique piece because he's small, but he, at the same time, he can play big. He's only about 6'6", 6'5", but he's stronger than most post players. I've seen him going into Hassan Whiteside's chest getting buckets when they played against Portland. And then at the same time, he has the agility to play out there on the perimeter and slide his feet. In today's game, he is what it is all about. Now, this play right here is a great play for Zion Williamson. Got to give shouts out to the Pelicans coaching staff. They used to run this play for Corey McGetty back in the day for the Clippers. He used to get downhill to the right. Zion obviously gets downhill with the left hand. Like how he is attacking the basket right there. This play puts his this shows everything that he can do. The quick in between the legs crossover, sees that nobody is there that can stop him on the strong side, on the weak side, only a wing defender. Zion knows to automatically attack the basket, showing the versatility in his game because he can play on the perimeter, but at the same time, he can post up. He can get it done in the post. Now you see Zion playing against a bigger defender, Valanciunas. No chance of staying in front of him. Zion gets quickly to his strong hand. Now we show you his strong hand because we know he wants to get to his left, but yes, he can set up the left by getting to his right. Quick move to the right, nice spin, splish the trap to get back to that left hand. Zion is truly taking over this game for the Pelicans. I like everything he's doing. What is truly scary for the league is how strong, how efficient he's been playing. This guy didn't get to play the first part of the season. He's obviously not in the best shape, and his offense has ways to go, and he's still dominating. I think in the next couple of years, we could be looking at Zion Williamson's NBA.
I agree. And when you watch him play, there's a simplicity that he brings to the game. He catches and he goes. He moves the ball quick. And you're right, B. He's undersized. So as a five, you know, we played the position. We say, man, just wall up. Make him score over you.
Not that
but
guy.
He jumps so high and so quick that he's in the air while guys are still sliding their feet. Now, the beauty in him being injured was he got to improve his three-point shooting. He got to sit back and watch the game of basketball. So he's in a perfect place. And when you talked about Alvin Gentry earlier, I think Alvin Gentry is just spoon-feeding him just enough to where he can grow, and you're going to see his game mature as he goes forward.
So I have a question for you, too. He had a lot of hype coming in. We all knew what he was capable of. We saw the tremendous athleticism in the highlights. Has there been anything that surprised you? For me, it's been that quick second jump.
Well, that didn't really surprise me. I saw that a lot at Duke. That's one of the things that truly amazed me, because I didn't have it when I played. I had that first jump, but that second jump, it was never there. He has that second jump kind of similar to, remember Antoine Jameson that we both played with?
Yep.
He has that quick second jump like Antoine Jameson, but he has the brute strength and the power to go through the big men that we talked about, guys like Steven Adams, Hassan Whiteside. He can take it right to their chest. So Zion is unique because he simplifies the game like you talked about. He can play everywhere. He can play on the perimeter. He can get it done inside. And then in this league where everybody loves to switch to pick and roll, he says, okay, every time you put a small guy on me, a wing player or a point guard, I'm not stepping out to the three-point line like a lot of these modern-day bigs. I'm going to seal big in the lane, and I'm going to punish the smaller player. If you put a bigger player on him, he says, okay, this guy can't move his feet with me. I'm going to the perimeter. You made an excellent point. The game is simple for him.
Yep.
I'm bigger than you, and if I'm not bigger than you, I'm faster and I'm quicker than you. I'm just going to play to my strengths.
I think what surprised me is in a half court. You know, I thought this would be a system with the Pelicans where they'd have to run and throw him lobs. He'd have to be a rim runner. But he's been incredibly effective in a half court, like you said, B, thinking the game of basketball. He's also a willing passer. Mm. He hasn't stepped in with the mindset, I'm the number one overall pick. I've got average 30 or 40 a game. He plays within a team concept. And for a guy that's willing to go out and rebound, we know that's one of the things that transfers. If you are a double-double guy in college, more than frequently, you're going to be a double-double guy in the NBA. But him scoring over centers, playing in a half court, I didn't expect that. I thought the athleticism would be there, but him using it in the right moments.
And then when you look at what he's done his last eight games, averaging 25 points per game, look at he has so much farther he can go in his offensive development.
Yep.
He hasn't developed the mid-range jumper yet. Still isn't a great three-point shooter. Could be a better free throw shooter. If he just improves one of those things over the course of the next 3 years, we're looking at a guy that's going to be averaging 25 to 28 points per game per night. And at the same time, we know he's going to be in better shape. Well, I tell you, the Pelicans got a good one. If you're going to lose Anthony Davis, it's good to lose him and replace him with a guy like this.
Well, think about this, too. Not just is the game simple, not is he just moving the basketball, He's so humble, man.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Seriously, like, this kid has every – he's a throwback in the sense that a lot of kids today, even our young rookies, a little cocky, a little arrogant, be trying to figure out the game of basketball. We've been there before, but this kid knows I've got to work harder. Mm-hmm. I've got to grow. And I think for him, coming from that Coach K system over at Duke and bringing that to the NBA, he's having a lot of success early, and he hasn't stopped to toot his own horn yet.
And you can tell. His teammates enjoy playing with him. You've heard Alvin Gentry talk about how he is evolving into a leader, but his teammates like and respect him, and that's a two-way street, respect.
We saw that a lot at Duke. He knew that everything was going to be about him because he was the YouTube sensation. Mm-hmm. He made sure that he did every interview with his teammates.
I love it.
He didn't want it to be about Zion Williamson. He wanted it to be about the Duke Blue Devils.
Smart guy.
It hurts me to say that, but yeah. He learned a lot at Duke University.
Look at you. He's about to break out in hives, people, giving them a compliment. Oh. My goodness. LeBron James is the opponent for tonight, right? These two will be facing each other for the first time. Two potentially of the most hyped individuals to come into the NBA ever, especially when you consider now in this day and age of social media. What are you expecting from this matchup, even though I know they're not going to be pitted directly against each other?
Well, the one thing I know from playing against LeBron and competing against him, he's extremely aware of the circumstances around him. He knows, even though they have different games, Brendan, we talked about it, Zion Williamson is pegged to be the next LeBron James. He's a physical specimen. So LeBron knows what's at stake. He's going to have his moments where he's going to play some one-on-one with Zion, see if we can't see that matchup a few times. But I love that LeBron, later in his years, he's working his way into games, facilitating, passing the ball. He's a true point guard. I know we kind of scoffed at it. He's always been a point guard, but he's a true point guard, and the points come later, and he's averaging 30. Come on, B.
Hey, listen. We know what LeBron is. He is having an incredible season, and I look forward to the matchup that we are going to have tonight. It's going to be few and far in between, but sometimes because of the way the game is today, with all the switching of the pick and rolls, we're going to get Zion versus LeBron James. Yeah. We're going to get to see what that looks like. You said it. LeBron is one of the more self-aware NBA stars out there. He understands that some people thought that he was a little bit washed up this summer. Mm. And when he's coming in playing against the new young star, the young pup that's coming up, LeBron's going to want to send a little bit of a message. So when they do get matched up, look for LeBron to be a little bit aggressive. And let's not sleep on that Anthony Davis-Zion Williamson matchup either.
A little homecoming, right? Old squad.
Exactly.
Old bond there.
Old team. Time for our poll question. Who is the most exciting player to watch? LeBron or Zion?
Come on now.
It's a win-win.
Come on now. Listen, hey, I understand Zion's coming, but LeBron's still the most exciting player to watch. When you talk about step-back threes, electric dunks, the passing, it's still LeBron James.
Box shots.
Yeah, we'll answer it. Who'd you spend your last dollar on? You know, you got to go see a LeBron game or a Zion game. Not that Zion isn't great, but hey.
But what about that guy?
That's a good one.
What about that guy right there?
You could throw him in the poll question.
He should be the unanimous MVP this season.
It might happen.
He should be unanimous.
That's the first of our TNT doubleheader.
What?